All right, guys, this is it. The third related Bluey review on my channel. The Christmas special, the original, the review I did today, and now this. I'm going to review on the best Bluey episode since the episode movies. So, let's get started with you. Cue the intro. Hey guys, it's Lamborock Strikes Back once again. Hope you are having a good day so far. My day's been pretty stressful because there's a buttload of fucking train delays recently. So, and due to that, guys, I need to do this quickly, guys, because my phone is 32% charged. So I'm going to try my best to remember bits of it. So anyway, guys, so today I'm going to review on Bluey the Sign came out this year. So base the plot is... It takes place immediately after Ghost Basket, and where Bandit and Chilli were doing a role play of them Chilli buying the house and teaching the kids what moving house is like, and then they're basically they're planning to move to a new house. They're basically about planning to move away. Then Bluey told her friends at school, and they were shocked. And then Bluey said why is there always a happy ever after? And basically they're about to do there's a wedding for Bandit's brother, and then basically the wedding went off for a bit. And it's up to them to make up for it and get the wedding back together. And then they have to decide if they're going to move out or not. And that's basically what the plot is. Now, I have reviewed Bluey today recently. I hope you guys enjoyed the longer way of 1 year review on my channel. And that is Bluey. And as a matter of fact, guys, I didn't get into the show until last. I didn't get into this series until last year, so that means I was 5 years late on this series. That's right, I was literally 5 years late on this series, kind of like I did with Casagrandes. I didn't watch that show until 2021 during the third lockdown. I didn't watch a show until last year at my holiday at Spain last year. So that's when I first discovered, that's when I first watched Bluey. So, and I gotta say this, guys, is this episode deserved the 9.9 on IMDb? Yes, it got a... Yes, it does! This deserved the 9.9 on IMDb indeed. The Bluey, the Sign, is a freaking phenomenal episode. And honestly, guys, this could have been the season 3 finale of Bluey instead of Surprise. Yep, I said it. This should have been the series finale, season 3 finale instead of Surprise. Surprise is still a good episode, but I do prefer this to be the season 3 finale than this. So, I mean, let's get into the positive. There's no negatives, by the way, guys. There's nothing wrong with this episode. It's all a positive review, so of course. So anyway, first off, what can I say about the animation? The animation is absolutely amazing, of course. This is easily the best. This is, of course, the best looking out of the Disney Junior shows. And I gotta say, I mean, the voice acting in this episode was so phenomenal. It had, everyone was doing their hardest best to make this, to please the fans of Bluey, from kids, adults, and even teenagers. And yeah, Bluey is for all ages. Yeah, there is some adult themes, and there's some mature themes that can relate to adults. So, and Bluey was such a great character in this one. And then she was kind of worried about that she was never going to see her friends again. She's kind of worried about she won't see her her muffin and socks again. And this episode really relates to me. I mean, because if you guys probably know that me and my family moved out of my childhood home back in 2021, and this episode, I can totally relate to Bluey. Like when I heard that I'm moving to me and my family are moving to a new place, a new town, a new location, a new house, I'm moving, I was pretty shocked that I'm actually doing it. That was like the very first time I'm ever gonna move, And this is also kind of reminds me of the final episode of Harvey Girls Forever, where Lotta had to move away from Harvey Street. It's kind of like that. So that episode and this episode, I can totally relate to Bluey. So yeah, Bingo and Chilli and the others were absolutely great. And that scene with the wedding was off at first, but then later they make Bluey say make up. They decide to get married. And then the K-I-S-S-I-N, sang by Bluey and Bandit, and of course with Muffin in the car. It was a great scene, and of course my favorite scene in this episode is the party scene, the wedding scene, and all that stuff. Everyone's all dancing, they're all having so much fun celebrating the wedding, and they all just everyone's all dancing. Yes, there's even a flop, even the way Bingo and Socks and even Muffin all dance and the stuff. And even the floss is in this series. Now, even though I hate flossing, even though I hate Fortnite with a burning passion, which that game is overrated as hell. And I cannot believe that the freaking people in college talk about that game nonstop, which I'm gonna make fun of. I'm gonna poke fun of Fortnite in the next episode of Topic Stuff. So stick around to that, guys. So I have terrible bad memories of that game. Horrible bad memories. So yeah, but I do like the flossing in this show. That's one exception of all of the Sonic films. That's the only one exception I can totally I accept. Sorry, as an obligation. Back I was saying, guys. And then the ending scene. I know a lot of people cried at the end, and people said that they actually falling. People have tears in that song. Now, I know there's some people, Bluey fans actually cry at the end, guys. This is gonna shock you guys. I didn't cry. Yes. Hear me right, guys. I said it on camera. I did not cry at the end of this episode. I know you guys are gonna typing your keyboards or typing your phone, you're thinking, oh, Labrador strikes back. Why didn't you cry at the end of this episode? Why didn't you cry at the end of the episode? Why didn't you cry at the end of the episode? All this stuff. Look, guys, I don't cry in TV shows. I don't cry in movies. I didn't cry at the end of Endgame, Infinity War, No Way Home, and this. I didn't cry at all. Yes. I didn't cry at all. Even Marley and Me, freaking Marley and Me, good movie, but the ending was so sad. But yeah, so the ending was very emotional, and I like the scene where now this may contain spoiler territory. If you have not seen this episode yet, guys, skip ahead in the part of the video. Or if you haven't seen the episode, just thank you guys for watching, subscribe to our channel, like and share your friends, and exit the video, then watch the episode and come back and watch this review after you finish watching the episode, guys. And in the end scene where Bandit actually took the get rid of the sold sign and then put the sell sign, and they got rid of the sign and the stuff, and they basically decided to stay in the in the house and stuff. And yeah, I do miss my childhood home, but thankfully I'm not like Bandit, just take the soul sign and then throw it away. But well, it's a good thing I never did that, because there is a because the sign when I saw my old house with my family, it was stuck in really already, and they tie up the thing, so I can't pull it out. So, but I do understand it's only a TV show, guys. It only works in TV shows, but in my world, I can't take out the soul sign because it's stuck in the thing. So yeah, good thing I'm not like Bandit, guys. If I did that like Bandit, for example, guys, I wouldn't move to that house my new house I'm currently living right since for 3 years. But thankfully they decided to stay, and sorry, there's a train in the background, like I was saying, guys. And they decided to stay, and the episode ends. And honestly, guys, what a powerful and emotional ending to the series. I know it's a show made towards toddlers, but this is such a powerful emotional ending. And honestly, guys, this could have been the series finale to Bluey. This should have been the series finale to Bluey. I mean, I know they're making season 4 coming next year, but I do prefer this to be the series finale of Bluey. This should have been the season 3 finale, but if they did end it after this episode, end the series after this episode, it would have been a perfect way to close the series. And hell, it even might be one of the best. If it ended after this episode, it would have been up there with Amphibia finale, and even Meanwhile Futurama, and even the Futurama Meanwhile finale as one of the best series finale I've ever seen in an animated series. But it's an example, guys. We're getting season 4 still, guys. I'm guessing they're making about 2 more, 3 more seasons, despite the show is so popular. But honestly, guys, this is the best episode since Movies. If you thought Movies was a fantastic, is my favorite episode of the entire show, which along with Sleeping Time, which that's also another great episode. This is hands down the best. This is has to be the best episode of the entire show. I absolutely love the series, love this episode. I do want to watch it more often, and I didn't watch this episode when it first came out, because the reason why I was far behind on the series at the time, I was on season 2 at the time, so I had to catch up during the time, but it was absolutely worth the wait. So hopefully now when season 4 comes out next year, I can go straight to season 4. So overall, this Bluey the Sign is an absolute fantastic episode and a phenomenal episode. And they couldn't end season 3 after this episode, during this episode, instead of Surprise. Surprise is still a great episode, but this should have been the season 3 finale. Overall, this episode gets a 10 out of 10. It's an amazing, brilliant masterpiece. So yeah, now I really do 2 Bluey related in one day on my channel. Now I have to end this now, guys, because my phone is about to die, about 29% charge. So when I get home, I'm gonna upload to YouTube and all that stuff, and get ready. Because I'm actually off of it. So yeah, anyway, guys. I haven't decided what my next review is gonna be, because next week I got some few rants I want to do on my channel. So I do want to rant on Madden Web next week, hopefully. So I'm not sure when I might take a little break from reviews. I'll do another review probably a week after I do a rant on it. So I got 2 rants in the works for next week. I got Madden Web rant coming next week, and a potential Sweet Life movie redo rant. So those are my next upcoming rants. So I'm here, guys. Thank you guys for watching. Subscribe, channel, like, and share the rants. Until next time, goodbye. I mean, goodbye.